Today we're going to show you how to calculate path contribution time histories from a transfer path analysis model in SimCenter Test Lab. Here I already have a frequency-based model, and I want to calculate some time histories that I can listen to and evaluate the different paths. If I go to Tools Add-ins, I can add in a little add-in here called Time Domain TPA. And in Time Domain TPA, if I have a throughput file of all my different time histories, all sampled at the same rate, I can put those in the input basket. Read from input basket here, and then I can take a nice look here. And yeah, I got a bunch of time histories. These are all accelerations. They're not the time domain forces. I'm going to indirectly calculate those forces by clicking on calculate here. It's going to take these time histories and put them through the TPA model. And what that means is it's going to calculate the forces at each path in the time domain, then calculate the contribution in the time domain of the sound pressure to the acoustic target that I have. If I have a vibration target, it would do the same, and I can even listen to that. When it's done calculating, I can go over here to Navigator, and I could take a look at what we just calculated. It's right here. I've got a whole bunch of names here. So I'll switch this to horizontal detail view just to give myself a little more space to interpret the data. And I'm going to add some attributes here. I'm going to pick standard function, and I'm going to search for down here the words TPA. And I'll pick TPA path, TPA result type. And here you can see at one of my target locations, I have the total contribution of sound. So this is like the measured or calculated sound. I have the same ID right here, but it has a different TPA path ID. It's a partial contribution. It's the sound pressure contributed to the total from this path. So that's one of these path contributions. And I could go here and listen to these two by picking audio replay. And I could hear the total if I wanted to. Or I could hear the path. Rather than listen to them one at a time by dragging and dropping them out of here, a more interesting way to listen to the data is to use this other add-in, an add-in called TPA Synthesis. So I've added that in, and I have a new workbook. Go to that workbook, and I can say load time domain TPA results. It brings up the model for me. Here's my acoustic targets, and I can pick, if I want, a subset of time domain data. So I'll say apply segment selection. I'll go to replay here, and I can start listening. Here's the original measured data, and by contrast, I can listen to the time domain TPA model. Over on this side, you can see there's a number of paths showing. And when I'm listening to the time domain TPA model, I can turn on and off individual paths to hear their contribution to the overall or how it affects it. So I just do that by clicking, and I can pick the paths until I find the ones that are important. If I want, I can also view a spectrum of the data. So I can come up here, say add eavesdropping, and I can see a live spectrum of this path. And here I can even do something like apply a low-pass filter on a path and take out certain frequency content. So maybe I could remove everything below 200 hertz. And you can see that it did that. And so on any one of these individual paths, I can add a filter if I want. I can turn the path on and off, take it out entirely and hear the effect. And if I even had paths with modifications applied and things like that, I could listen to those as well. Thank you.